Okay, good afternoon, everyone. Today we are meeting, as I told you last time, we are going to do a very, very interesting chapter of linguistics, which is going to connect all the dots which have been sprinkled in your memory. And sometime you will be wondering that, okay, one lecture was given on how to pronounce the word, one part of lecture was talking about how to make the words out of the sounds which were taught to you, then we taught you how to make the words, now what? What is left behind? English grammar is also part of linguistics, but we don't want to make it boring, banal, and cumbersome by teaching you English grammar. What we want to do is that sometime English grammar as such on the paper will never attract you, but some of the aspects of English grammar, if are pulled out of the context and taught to you, you'll find them very interesting. Today, we have met here to discuss two very important aspects of linguistics. First is we're going to talk about semantics. And second, we are going to talk about the another aspect, yet very closely related with that, so much so that sometimes students use them synonymously, but they are not synonymous with each other, right? So semantics is a total separate branch of linguistics, and semiotics is a totally different branch of linguistics. Today, the era in which we are living in, when we talk about communicating with each other. Linguistic is the scientific study of language. Why do we learn language? Because we have to communicate with each other. But today we communicate via our mobiles, where certain emoticons have replaced your language. They save your time. They are funny. They are very popular among the students. And you use them 24 hours, right? But do we have a discourse? Do we have a set of rules? Can we analyze even the language of those emoticons, right? And I hope you immediately understand when I say emoticons, what I'm talking about. I'm talking about certain icons which express your emotions, emoticons, right? We are going to today talk about the language of emoticons also. Sometime human beings, and especially those human beings who share a very, very compassionate relationship with each other, should not or may not talk to each other, but still they express their emotions to each other. What you call body language, right? Either it is a thief to police inspector, students to teacher, right? So when you come to the class and we are saying, okay, are you ready for presentation? And everybody seems to be busy. We ask, who will make the presentation? And students are as if they have become the presidents of the country, they are so busy, they will try to avoid the eye contact, they'll say, sunai nahi sir, kisse baat kar rahe ho? Right? All these kind of expressions and emotions which immediately dawn upon us sometime, of course, deliver the message to us. Can we also understand the language when sometime it is not expressed? Or is there a high risk that non-verbal communication most of the time will create a lot of confusion rather than removing the confusion? But for your kind information, 65%, or let me say it, because now I'm adding emoticon also in this, the language of WhatsApp, language of Facebook, and so on and so forth, 70 to 75% of our everyday communication is without words, without sentences, without languages. So remember, when you give a kind of look to your friend and your friend knows, so aapko yahan se bhagna hai class se. So you just give a close eye look to your friend and make a gesture and first you move out. For instance, this I have observed very closely when we are invigilators in the hall, Atisha Hall, and we are moving. And then suddenly somebody will, you know, pass a message to another one who is sitting there in the corner that let's meet in the bathroom, washroom. Right? And then two students, then three students, then six students, and they are there chai pe charcha ke liye for almost half an hour, because they have not gone there for whatever it seems like they have gone there. They have gone there for a different purpose. And then we teachers pull you out from there, right? Because so language communication is not necessarily a slave of language, right? One part. Second part, that means that we do not need grammar, we do not need words. You may be very good at English language, you may be very good at words, you can know total grammar. Still, sometime you might have heard an expression like this even by the great professors. P. people who are native speakers of English, they'll say, no, I did not mean to say that. Right? I'm sorry, you misunderstood me. Then why didn't you say clearly? Why didn't you mean to say? Or is it that sometimes language is so fishy that you will not be capable to express exactly what you want to say? Right? And then we are learning a language which is not our mother tongue. If that is the problem in our mother tongue also. So let me ask this question and you muse about this, ponder over about this. Does it happen with all of you sometime, even in your mother tongue, which is Tibetan language or any other language, that is happens in my case with Hindi, that sometime when I'm trying to say something, I'm not capable to say. I'm struggling. I'm trying to find the words. I'm trying to find the sentences. I'm trying to reshuffle the words to put them properly. And I'll say, okay, let me try this sentence, that sentence, this sentence. It's still a failure. That means languages are not about only grammar. Languages are not only about knowing the meaning of the words, right? Languages are about more than that. Languages are about trying to understand the meaning of words, meaning of sentences. So you might have learned phonetics, you might have crammed all the vocabulary words by your heart, and you are perfect at grammar. Still, you will not be able to express yourself well. Why? What are the solutions of that? And under which part of linguistics we should discuss this problem? The problem of meaning, problem of context, problem of filling the gaps, and problem of how do we deal and come up with a solution with that? That's where semantics come into picture. Semantics, as the word suggests, is just a simple analysis of meaning. So I have taken a clip of a very interesting advertisement, which is a kind of ironical. So have a look at this advertisement. I'm going to read it for you. Then I'll ask you if you also have such kind of examples in your language after me sharing from Hindi language. Look at that. The words fire department. Do you know what is fire department? Right? Fire department make it sound like they are the ones who are starting fire. The name is fire department. That name should have been extinguish the fire department, right? Extinguish department. We don't call the police the crime department. Also, the bomb squad sounds like a terrorist gang. You call them bomb squad, those who are going to deactivate the bombs. That means there is something wrong with these words. The same is true of wrinkle cream. There is a cream which comes into the market, wrinkle cream, right? Now, does it create wrinkle or is it going to remove wrinkle? But the name of the cream is wrinkle cream. Doesn't it sound like it causes wrinkles? And why would a doctor prescribe pain pills? I already have pain. I need relief pills. But you don't call them relief pills. You call them pain pills. Let me give you an example from Hindi. I come from a family where most of the time when kids in the initial years will have loose motions, तो मुझे याद है मेरी दादी और माँ बोलती थी कि जाओ दस्त वाली गोली लेके आओ, right? So we will go to the chemist and we'll say दस्त वाली गोली दे दो. The kid is already having dust stools. He is already suffering with loose motions. I'm supposed to say that give me a pill which is going to stop it. Rather than that, what do we say? And look at the understanding. And the chemist also understands and he gives me a pill. I never cross check it. Dust रोकने वाली दी है ना. नो, इट्स ऑल अंडरस्टूड. वी ऑल नो द लैंग्वेज, राइट? दैट मींस लैंग्वेजेस इज बियॉन्ड दैट ग्रामर. लैंग्वेजेस, द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ लैंग्वेज और द वे दे आर रिएक्टिंग इन द सोसाइटी इज बियॉन्ड वर्ल्ड पावर एंड सो फोर्थ, राइट? सो लेट्स फर्स्ट, बिफोर वी ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड सेमेंटिक्स, लेट्स फर्स्ट ट्राई टू कोप विद सम प्रॉब्लम्स इन इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज, राइट? सो आई हैव मेड सम काइंड ऑफ इंटरेस्टिंग एक्सरसाइजेस. How many times you ever had to say this, I did not mean to say that? Let's look at some of the sentences. If you are wondering why I have changed the color, because that's what you're supposed to do. The same color sentences are the ambiguous pair. That means, let's discuss first that. So, first and second. She called him a fool. Right? She called him a fool. She called her a taxi. Now, I called, let's not try the first one, I called him intelligent and I called her a taxi. Is she a taxi? Is the second sentence wrong? ग्रामेटिकली कैन एनीबडी चैलेंज कि नहीं सर ग्रामेटिकली ये सेंटेंस गलत है. द सेंटेंस इज एब्सोल्युटली फाइन राइट. आई कॉल्ड हर अ टैक्सी राइट. यू वॉन्ट अ विजुअल ऑफ दैट. लुक एट दैट. यू वॉन्ट मी द मैन सेड कॉल मी अ टैक्सी प्लीज एंड द लेडी इज कंफ्यूज सो शी इज आस्किंग you want me to get you a taxi or tell you you are a taxi right. Look at this right. The man said call me a cab and the girl replied laughingly okay you are a cab. But that's not what he meant. The man is saying call a cab for me. So how should we avoid this ambiguity. The sentence is not wrong grammatically. Right, and I'm not going in syntax. I can explain this if necessary. I'll do it later. Right, quickly let me tell you this. She is subject, called is verb, him is object, and a fool is object complement. I made him monitor of the class. So I made her monitor. So I subject, made verb, her object. And object complement is what did I make her? Monitor. Right? But this is not framed this way. Actually, this should have been framed. He called a taxi for her to avoid the ambiguity. The sentence is absolutely fine, but the meaning is still going to create problem. Right? Could you understand why I gave you this example? Just to show you that sometime you will use right grammar. Sometime you will know absolutely what does the word mean. Still the sentences will create problem. We are trying to go and discuss the semantic solutions of these. First, let's understand the problem. And let's also try to analyze, do you also in your mother tongue or in your everyday communication come across sentences like that where after saying sentence you laugh and you say, oh my God, it turned out to be a funny sentence. I will give you some examples in Hindi. Look at that. These are high school boys. First sentence, these are high school boys. And look at the second sentence and look at the tone. I'll say, boys are after all boys. Right? Now the word boy, the meaning, we all know what is going to be the meaning of the word boy. Here, it's a different kind of semantic issue. It is the issue of denotation and connotation. Boy need not to mean only a physical adult or pre-adult boy. Boy means all the issues related with boys. They flirt, they lie, they don't give a damn, they sting, they don't care about their clothes, they throw their socks here and there, and then people say, boys will at all always be boys. Right? So here in the second sentence, it's not about that I'm introducing you to boys. Here the meaning of the boy is totally different. Right? For instance, Dhoni, every time when he is talking to media, he'll say, my boys played well. He is 55 almost, right? And he's calling Sachin Tendulkar also, my boy. He is almost in his late 50s and going into 60s. Are they really boys now? Right? But this is the word which we use because it will mean something else. What kind of semantic problem is this? Do you also come across a problem like that in your language where you have used that word so much for that particular thing that now either it is a food object or a practice or any object, you just remember sometime by logo. So we don't say, I have bought mobile. We'll say, I have apple. If you have apple, eat it up. Don't go for lunch. But then say, have you lost your mind? I have apple. I can talk on that. Right? So, I mean, just as a joke, one of my nephews, a small nephew said, he saw the Apple iPad in my this thing, and he said, Chacha, I want Apple 10. I said, okay, I'll give you Apple 10. And he was so happy. He started to dance. He went to the granny, my mom, and said, Chacha is going to get Apple 10. And she got angry. She said, you always spend money unnecessarily. And I said, relax. I went to market, I bought 10 apples, right? I came home and I said, here, apple 10. Or you just replace it, call it 10 apples. And he got angry. He said, are you a fool or something? I did not say this, these apples. I said, I want the mobile apple 10. But I said, the language you use says this. So sometimes can we deliberately make fun of language like this? That was a deliberate effort, by the way, on my part. Look at this third one. this you have to do right now. I, right? All of you know the meaning of I, right? That's the whole practice. We all know the meaning of the I who is sitting here. Now let's try to use the word and make at least two sentences with different meaning. One, of course, is going to be I. Make two, and I'll be very happy if you can make even 7, 5, 10 sentences. Meaning should be different. So let's do that. I, E-Y-E. I'm not saying I. Right? E-Y-E. Use this word and try to make two or three sentences. The meaning should be different. Be a bit quick. Anybody who has come up with two sentences want to share? Yes, please.
All eyes on the blackboard.
Yes. And second?
Just one sentence, two meanings.
Oh, you mean to say one sentence. So what are the two meanings?
Grab all the eyes and put on the blackboard. Or focus.
So this sentence will have only one meaning. All eyes on the blackboard means concentrate there. What is the second meaning?
Second meaning,
eyes on blackboard. No, you mean have all the eyes and throw it on blackboard?
Not throw it. Put it on the blackboard.
Okay. Anybody else? Two sentences, and both the sentences should have different meaning. Yeah, please do that. I have two eyes, yes? I absolutely agree with that.
Don't give me that eye.
Don't give me that eye. The better sentence would have been, don't give me that look. We don't say eye here. Right? Anybody else? Mahatma Gandhi. Did he use the word eye and has written something which became a very famous sentence to avoid violence across the globe? Nobody remembers Mahatma Gandhi's His Holiness uses this sentence a lot on public platforms. An eye for an eye is going to make the whole world blind. Now what does he mean? Am I going to take my eye and pull her eye? An eye for an eye means what? Here, what does it mean, eye? An eye for an eye is going to make the whole world blind. What does he mean by this?
Tit for tat,
in a violent sense, right? You have killed two of my soldiers, I'll kill four of your soldiers. Then where will it end? Should we kill each other like this? So His Holiness uses this in the sense of forgiveness. He says, if you are brave, the greatest thing is to forgive, not to take revenge, right? It's a beautiful philosophy. Here, look at the use of the word I, right? You cannot take it literally. Right? And another normal sentence will be, my eye is itching. Let me go to the eye doctor. Right? But when you make plural of this sentence or plural of this word eye, it becomes eyes. Right? Can you use the word eyes and come up with any sentence? This you can use in this sense, that he was showing me the eyes. Right? The teacher was showing me the eyes. Now, not like that. Look into my eyes. It's just that he was trying to intimidate me, right? So we are also going to talk about this semantic problem. How come one word is capable to have different meanings? And you'll be surprised to know that there are so many words in English now which are nowhere related with the dictionary meaning, but they are always used in connotative meaning, right? That dictionary meaning. For instance, somebody will say, oh, he's not a man, he's a dog. Right? It has become so famous that now calling a boy a dog is a normal thing. Right? But we know that this is also insult of a human being, because dogs are supposed to be faithful. And we call a person dog when that person has shown any trace of infidelity, being unfaithful. Right? Look at the next two. Meet me near the bank. Right? This example I always give to my students. Zomato guy calls. And I say, okay, meet me near the bank. And he says, sir, bank ke paas to bahut bada IBA. Right? But I did not mean river bank.
I meant SBI Bank. So bank also has two meanings, right? And I will only say meet me near the bank. What should you understand when you listen or come across a word like this? Should you ask for a clarification, or should the speaker before using such kind of sentence should be clear and always put an adjective before this? So how can I avoid the confusion? I will say meet me near SBI Bank. Meet me near Axis Bank. Meet me near River Bank is going to be totally different. You got my point what I'm saying? So think about this. Are such examples also available in your language where we sometimes have one word which can have two meanings and the meaning can be totally confusing and we use it in our everyday activities. Right? Look at the next one. I have a bat. Right? Of course, those who are cricket lovers will immediately say, oh, you have a bat. Give it to me. I want to put it into my hand and I give you a black bird with leathery feather and a very slimy touch. And I give it to your hand and I say, no, not this bat. Bat matlab chamgadar. Right? So, can be confusing. So, how can I avoid this? I can say, I have a cricket bat. Now, look at the stupidity of the language. Bat already means cricket bat. Why am I saying I have a cricket bat? What else you use bat for? Right? But then you are in India, right? I grew up seeing my granny washing the clothes with a bat. Right? Dhoke, kapde dhone wala bat. So then it's better that you always qualify a noun when you know that that noun can be confusing. A semantic problem. Look at the next. If the chair will allow me, when you go to conferences, seminar, you might have heard this sentence. If the chair will allow me, I will speak for another 10 minutes. So I'll say, if the chair will allow me, I will speak for more 10 minutes. How chair can allow me? Right? I mean to say the person who is presiding over the conference or sitting there as authority. Right? If chair will allow me. Now, chair does not mean, this is the funny aspect of language, right? Now, feminists said that earlier there used to be a word chairman. Whatever, either it is a female or a male, the word was always chairman. And feminists said, oh my God, this is an insult of the dignity of a woman. How can you always use the word chairman? Right? Literally, dictionaries had to remove this word and they used the neutral person, neutral word person. So now we never say chairman. What do we say? Chairperson. Right? And to avoid even that, we'll say if the chair will allow me. If let's say somebody will not understand, they'll say how chair will allow you. Then better you put another word with that and say if the chairperson will allow me. We can avoid the ambiguity. Look at the next one. Shooting is prohibited in park. Which shooting? Am I talking about photo shooting or am I talking about violent shooting? Can be confusing. And he painted a car. He painted a car. Did you paint a car or did you draw a car? Huh? How do you know? If I say my nephew painted a car, am I grammatically wrong? No. But if I say the painter painted the car new, that means in car garage somebody has painted the real car. All I am trying to do is make you aware that before you understand semantics, you will have to understand why semantics is useful for you. Otherwise, we just come and give you the lectures and you sometimes get fascinated by certain words and we forget that. That is not something which we want in this lecture. Right? So other examples, look at that. This is one of the title of the book. Sometimes when you remove even the punctuation mark, it can be pretty dangerous. Look at this last sentence. I am hungry. Let's eat, grandma. Right? Look at the second sentence. I am feeling like a cannibal. Let's eat, grandma. Right? All I have done is I have just removed this comma. Or agar aapne comma yaha, comma matlab you have to stop. So I'll say, let's eat, grandma. That means you eat with grandma. If you will remove that comma, what does it mean? Let's eat, grandma. We will turn into cannibals. Sentences can be dangerous that way. Where you have to pause. Right? It kehte hai na Hindi mein arth ka anarth ban jata hai. Right? So these are just some brainstorming kind of exercises. just to see that yes, languages will need more than grammar and some stuff. So let's talk about this. These are some of the examples. Look at these sentences, right? Lexical ambiguity, I'm going to come to that, but some funny examples. Look at this sentence. I saw her duck. Duck ka matlab kya hota hai? It's a bird. The another word is, those who play football, you must know what does duck mean. Thoda sa jhuk jaan. Right? So I saw her duck. Agar main aap pe ekdam se aise bottle fekhun, the immediate reaction of your body will be, you will little bit cower down. Your body will shrug a bit. Right? So I saw her duck. Am I saying this, that I saw her duck, or am I saying I saw her duck? Look at the second sentence. The chicken is ready to eat. Right? The first, the chicken is all prepared, let's eat chicken. The second is, there is chicken and he is waiting for the food. So the chicken is ready to eat. Now, anybody will help me to remove the ambiguity from here by reframing the sentence? How can we remove the ambiguity? I saw her walking walking the duck with, right? Or for instance, simple is, I saw, right, the duck with her, right? Look at this sentence. The chicken is ready to eat. Iska passive banaiye. Passive matlab passive nahi banana. Is phrase ko passive mein badal dijiye. The chicken is ready to be eaten. Ab dekhiye, aapko koi confusion nahi paida karega. इस सेंटेंस को मैंने क्या बोल दिया? The chicken is ready to be eaten by you. But I'm not saying by you. The chicken is ready to be eaten. Right? I want to even make it shorter. Chicken is ready to be eaten. So ready to be eaten. That's all. Ready to be eaten. And it will avoid ambiguity. What I'm saying is, over the years as an English teacher, when I check the answer sheets of students, sometimes very funny sentences come out. Right? And I know that the student is very good, student knows grammar, the student is aware of the meaning of the word, the student is not capable to take out the ambiguity. Right? These are those sentences which can be ambiguous sentences, and now with the help of some theory, we are going to learn how to avoid that ambiguity. Right? Semantic ambiguity. Right? So semantics, by the way, is all about meaning of the sentences. I'm coming to that with some slides. We said that the best way to resolve semantic ambiguity was to rephrase. I just told you, rephrase the sentence, right? It's always better you rephrase that sentence. That is a clue for you in exams. If one sentence sounds which can create a lot of problem, please rephrase the sentence so that it will not create problem, right? Was to rephrase a sentence so that the intended meaning was clearer, better than before. How might we resolve the following ambiguities? Jessica is cold. What does this sentence mean, by the way? Jessica is cold. That girl is so cold, she does not respond to any feeling. Or Jessica is cold, give her a blanket. Now, the sentence is ambiguous. Right? For instance, you are sitting next to me and you will say, you know, Jessica is cold. I'll say, yeah, I agree with you. Again, you'll say, aray, Jessica is cold. I'll say, yeah, I agree with you. I met that girl. She is pretty cold, you know. Then I'll say, no, she will die. She is feeling cold. Then I'll say, oh. Then take this blanket. By that time, Jessica may die. Then you will have a movie like, Who Killed Jessica? That can be pretty dangerous. So how can you save Jessica here? Rephrase the sentence. Jessica is feeling cold. Don't say Jessica is cold. Your sentence is not wrong. Right? But by putting one extra expression or a phrase, by rephrasing it, you can help linguistics a bit. It's a contribution of yours towards linguistics. Right? Other, we will not do everything. For instance, look at that. Very normal. I hope you speak it every day. My brother does not use glasses. So what? He drinks directly from the bottle? Right? And bottle, when I say, you know, that person has bottle in the car. Right? Ya police pakad ke kya bolti hai? Aray, car mein bottle mili iske. Aray, bhai, paani nahi piyu main. Car mein bottle mili to kya hua? But hum sab kya samajhte hain? The moment I'll say, uski car mein bottle mili hai, bottle. Right? And we always say bottle. Maybe there may be a small kid. It can be a milk bottle. But we have taken, jo main keh raha tha na, ki kuch word अब डिक्शनरी मीनिंग से इतने दूर हो गए हैं कि इंडिया में अगर आप किसी को बोलोगे ना, अरे उसके हाथ में बॉटल देखी मैंने, राइट, अब मैं इसके ये बॉटल लेके आई क्लास के अंदर, राइट, एंड इमीडिएटली से बॉटल, बाप रे बाप, कैसे स्टूडेंट है, शराब पीता है क्लास के अंदर, एंड सडनली द मीनिंग विल चेंज. वेल, इट कैन बी अ वॉटर बॉटल, इट कैन बी अ मिल्क बॉटल फॉर अ बेबी और अ टॉडलर, व्हाट इज रॉन्ग इन दैट, बट सिमेंटिक्स कैन क्रिएट द. What do? You just put one adjective before that. Eyeglasses. What do you say? How do you avoid? My brother does not use eyeglasses. Use water bottle, use milk bottle, and then leave bottle by itself because it has got a different kind of meaning. Right? For instance, when I went to Hyderabad for my studies, I first time came to know that there was some problem in our hostel. So somebody came to our hostel and said, घास चाहिए क्या? Right, I was very angry. And he said, घास चाहिए क्या? I said, I looked at me and I said, do I look like a donkey or something? Why is he asking me, घास चाहिए क्या? I said, no, I don't want. He said, फिर सोच ले, एक ही पैकेट बचा है, घास चाहिए क्या? And I said, has he gone mad or something? Why is he asking me this? So when I talked to some of my friends, right, they said that in some of the hostels, you know, Punjab is pretty notorious for that, for drugs. अफीम जो होती है ना, अफीम को दे विल नॉट से ओपनली अफीम बिकॉज इट कैन बी अ काइंड ऑफ रिस्की वर्ड टू से, सो दे हैव यूज सर्टेन वर्ड्स फॉर दैट, राइट, सो दे विल यूज द वर्ड घास उसके लिए. और आप कोई भी दुनिया की कोई भी कंट्री में चले जाइए, राइट, इवन एयरपोर्ट पे आपसे पूछेंगे, आई होप दैट यू आर नॉट इंपोर्टिंग और एक्सपोर्टिंग द ग्रास, बिकॉज ग्रास हैज, आप बोलो अरे सर घास तो हमारे इंडिया में बहुत होती है, बोले अच्छा तुम्हारे घास, अरे सर हमारे कैंपस में उगती है घास, तो पुलिस आपको पकड़ के ले जाएगी. ग्रास, अनदर वन वर्ड विच विल टेल यू द सेमेंटिक्स कैन क्रिएट समटाइम फनी सिचुएशन, समटाइम प्रीटी अलार्मिंग सिचुएशंस, राइट. अनदर वार्म अप एक्सरसाइज, आई डोंट वांट यू टू राइट समथिंग, जस्ट थिंक लाइक दिस, व्हेन आई से दिस इज सिगमंड फ्रॉइड्स थ्योरी, use it when you know that your friends are hiding something in the heart and they don't want to speak about that. We use it in counseling session when students come to us and they are hiding something. So we'll not ask, "Aap problem bata." They'll say, "Nahi sir, koi problem nahi hai, bas aise hi aapse baat karni thi." Right? And we know that there is some problem. Then what a student say, "Sir, actually meri ek friend hai. Meri problem nahi hai sir. Meri ek friend hai sir, uske saath ye ho gaya." And we do understand what it is all about. We say, "Ha, your friend. So what about your friend?" And you put the burden on somebody else and you think we are such big fools who are living into a kind of alternative narration. We immediately understand. So it's a free association. Right? So let's play this game. Main ek word bolunga, right? Jisse puchunga, aapko ek second ka bhi time nahi lena hai. Not a single second. I will say the word, whatever comes in your mind. Whatever the first word. Hindi ya English. बाकी तो मैं नहीं समझ पाऊंगा. हिंदी या इंग्लिश का कोई भी वर्ड आपके दिमाग में आता है, यू विल जस्ट से, राइट, ओके. होम, होम, डॉग, बाइसिकल, टीचर, 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 लिंग्विस्टिक्स, हाँ, योर से semantics, okay, linguistics, look at those, pill, sofa, TV, okay, let's say TV, oh, you came with sofa when I said it came TV, okay, now what are we doing, when you are having such words in your mind, whatever is coming associated with that tells you that words have the meaning of association, right? Words are associated together. For instance, look at that, home, right? Some of you can say Tibet, some of you can say my bedroom, some of you can say my mom, some of you will say my place, some of you will say warm, love, affection, but when you open dictionary, home does not have any of these meanings. Right? But we all know that these can be possible meanings of the word home. Right? For instance, look at that. Pencil. When we use the word pencil, rubber. Anybody else? Pencil. So, and now, second rule. First is, so second, you will only say the words which are closely associated with that. मैं ऐसा नहीं कि पेंसिल बोला और आप बोलो सर एटम बॉम्ब राइट एंड आई से व्हाट इज द कनेक्शन आई से पेंसिल और आप बोलो सर मर्डर एंड यू आर अ काइंड ऑफ पर्सन यू कैन किल अ पर्सन विद पेंसिल सो व्हाट इंट्रोगेशन पुलिस पीपल डू दैट इट इज अ काइंड ऑफ ट्रेनिंग व्हिच इज गिवन टू देम व्हेन द कल्प्रिट इज नॉट स्पीकिंग समथिंग दे समटाइम यूज स्टूपिड वर्ड्स राइट दे समटाइम यूज द वर्ड व्हिच फॉर इंस्टेंस मान लीजिए पेंसिल से किसी का मर्डर हुआ है ही विल नॉट डायरेक्टली आस्क कल्प्रिट डिड यू किल हिम विद पेंसिल ही विल ऑब्वियसली से नो सो दे विल मूव अराउंड द वर्ड एंड यूज सिमेंटिक्स टीचर्स डू दैट मदर्स डू इट ऑल द टाइम्स राइट मदर्स जस्ट टू नो द ट्रुथ कि ये आम कौन खाया पीछे से मैं तो बाहर गई थी आम किसने खाया राइट सो माई मदर इवन हैड स्टोरीज लाइक दिस व्हेन आई यूज्ड टू स्टील अ लॉट ऑफ रसगुल्लास And then she'll come back and she'll say, Rasgulla kisne khaya hai? We three brothers will be quiet. They'll say, jisne bhi Rasgulla khaya hai, shaam ko uske bandar ki poonch ug jayegi. And I was so scared that every time I used to go to the back and my mom would immediately catch me. For quite a few years, I used to wonder that my mother must be an amazing person. How does she know that I had eaten that? Because she played all those tricks. Today I know, so I don't get me fooled. All you have to do is, Be calm, be a semantic champion. Anybody कोई pencil बोले कोई कुछ भी बोले tension नहीं लेना, right? So what is semantics? Right? I'll just read one sentence. Everything we are not going to read here. PPTs are for you, not for me to read and pass the time. So semantics, it means related to signs. Now this is a very interesting term for me because it is going to associate our sentence with semiotics in a way. Right? It is all related with signs. Sign, are we not learning about language? No. Right? This is a sign, my shirt is a sign, a color is a sign. Right? Today, we live in the world where, as I gave you the example, emoticons are signs. Right? Aapne kisi ko emoticon bheja. Do you get this reply? What does it mean? No. That person will send you another emoticon. Right? So, we are talking in the languages of signs today. Right? Main road pe chal raha hun aur red light aayi aur aap bolo, "Are, red light ke niche to kuch likha hua hi nahi hai. Rukna hai ki chalna hai ki kya karna hai?" No, you go across the globe, red light tells you to stop. That means it's a sign and it is telling you something to do. It has a language, it has a mouth. Right? So, semiotics talks about all these things. I'm skipping all these things. Now, this exercise is going to sum up all of our lectures we have done that. Right? Dhyan se in sentences, in words ko dekhiye. You did syntax also. There is a noun phrase. There is a verb phrase. There is an adjective phrase. There is an adverb phrase. And there is a prepositional phrase. Try to make sentences out of combination of these words. Huh? No, you can add, you can, but everything should come in this, right? First sentence mein sare aane chahiye, right? Jaise main ek banane ki koshish karta hun. The tiny mouse was reading on the very tall table only occasionally. Right? Don't go by images. Go by sentences and try to make something. So, can you come up with a second sentence? The tiny mouse was reading on the table. Here, I have deleted these two phrases. Which phrase? Adverb phrase and adjective phrase. Right? So, how many sentences we can make with something like this? Right? Now, why I am teaching this? Now, here, look this carefully. And now, what we are discussing here is linguistics' biggest gift to humanity. Right? Now, look at that. I am writing a sentence from literary aspect. Shakespeare is a writer. This is a sentence. Now, think about this problem. You go in exam and you write a sentence like this. Shakespeare is a writer. right? Because you have to write an answer on Shakespeare. After 3-4 sentences, again you write Shakespeare was a writer. Again you say he was a writer. And it becomes very tautological. It becomes problematic, not for you. It's a torture of the teachers also. Now comes, can semantics help us to say the same thing, because my answer is about William Shakespeare, but say it in a different way. And I'll not even cause boredom. Yes. Now what do we do? Ek cheez dhyan se suniyega. When you speak a sentence, sentence is horizontal. When you speak a sentence is horizontal. Right now when I'm saying, I am a boy, this is a room. Right? So horizontal sentence nikla hai. Aur sentence kaise padha rahega horizontally? I'm not saying writer is Shakespeare A. It will not make any sense. It has to be governed by grammar also. So Shakespeare is a writer. So when we make sentence, write in exam, you write horizontally. This is why your answer sheets are also like this. Kya aapko aise copy milti hai? Right? Ki aap likhe Shakespeare, aap aise likhna shuru karte hai. Shakespeare is a writer. Full spare second. Aise nahi likhta na? Right? Think about this. Why not? Because we speak horizontally, but we think vertically. ध्यान से सुनिएगा मैं क्या बोल रहा हूं. वी स्पीक हॉरिजॉन्टली, वी राइट डाउन सेंटेंसेस हॉरिजॉन्टली, बट वी थिंक वर्टिकली. एंड इन आवर एजुकेशन सिस्टम वी नेवर ट्रेन आवर स्टूडेंट्स वर्टिकली, वी ऑलवेज ट्रेन देम हॉरिजॉन्टली. दैट्स व्हाई आई रियलाइज दैट वी फेस प्रॉब्लम. तो इसको थोड़ा उल्टा करते हैं आज. अब हम क्या करने वाले हैं, वी आर गोइंग टू प्ले अ गेम इन विच we are going to pick up something horizontally, and I am writing some options here. You will have to pick up that word, replace one word, and make another sentence. Right? So look at that. You will understand in a while. These are few words, right? They are falling vertically. Now, I am a student who is writing some sentences. अब आपको क्या करना है? आपने, we all played this game, I'm sure. आपने एक बार एक game आता था ना पहले ऐसे, ऊपर से इस तरह से blocks गिरते हैं, right? और वो block गिरते हैं और नीचे आके वो set होते हैं और जैसे ही आपने एक line बना ली, एक line गायब हो जाएगी. We all have played that game. वही गेम आपको यहाँ खेलना है. एक मैं एग्जाम्पल करके बता रहा हूँ. मैं बोलना चाह रहा हूँ शेक्सपियर इज अ राइटर. अब एक बार तो एग्जाम में आंसर लिख दिया, अब मैं नहीं चाहता हूँ कि इसको रिपीट करूँ. I want to show how genius I am. So what can I do? I will replace now Shakespeare with the word. तो शेक्सपियर हट जाएगा, तो ये ऊपर से गिरा और ये गायब हो जाएगा और इसकी जगह क्या आ जाएगा? आप गड़बड़ है. पोइट इज अ राइटर. वेल एवरीबडी नोज पोइट इज अ राइटर, राइट? तो अब आपको कुछ यहां भी रिप्लेस करना पड़ेगा, राइट? सो लेट्स से ये रहा, द पोइट इज अ रेनेसांस मैन. दैट मींस ही वाज अ राइटर हु वाज राइटिंग इन रेनेसांस, राइट? सेकंड देखते हैं. मैं ये चाहता हूं दैट इसको मैं थोड़ा सा रिफ्रेस कर दूं. And I'll not say Shakespeare is a writer. I'll say Shakespeare composed dramas. Shakespeare composed poetry. Right? तो is a writer की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी मुझे. Right? अगला और करके देखते हैं. Literary giant. एक बार Shakespeare लिख दिया आपने. Second time what you supposed to do? Literary giant had composed lot of poems in Renaissance era. Right? Teacher will understand that you are talking about Shakespeare because the whole context is about Shakespeare. Right? Ab fir se dhyan se suniye.
if ever you face this problem, even in your mother tongue, that when you are talking, sometimes you'll say like, I want that, you know, and then you don't have a word. What happened? कि जो word गिर रहे हैं vertically, right? वो आपको मिल नहीं रहा है. कभी-कभी होता है ना, आपको गेम खेलते हैं, इधर मोड़ा उसको उधर मोड़ा, पता ही नहीं चल रहा है कहाँ गिरा है, और वो गलत जगह जाके गिर जाता है, right? Now that's the problem. What I'm saying is this: always remember, semantically train your mind with vertical axis. Don't bother about horizontal axis. Horizontal axis is governed by rule of combination. Vertical axis is governed by rule of selection. मैं आऊँगा इस पे. अभी सिर्फ समझाया है, इसकी मैंने बहुत सारी पीपीटी बनाई है. Exactly that's what you're supposed to do. क्या मैं द टाइनी माउस को हटा के एनिमल लिख सकता हूं? द स्मॉल एनिमल वॉज रीडिंग ऑन द वेरी टॉल टेबल. कैन आई डू दैट? मीनिंग तो वही रहा, राइट? और कुछ आप चेंज कर सकते हैं? देखिए, वर्टिकली क्या रिप्लेस करके क्या लगा सकते हैं? वर्टिकली कैन यू रीफ्रेज एंड री लुक एट दिस सेंटेंस? Or let's simplify this. Look at this sentence. Cat sat on mat. Tell me how many sentences we can replace and make it. Cat sat on mat. Can I replace cat with some other words? No, I'm not saying it has to be only about cat. I'm saying how many words in your mind can. मैंने बोला ना cat. Cat बोलते ही क्या मैं बोल सकता हूँ? Dog sat on mat.
Yes.
Can I say animal sat on mat?
Yes.
Can I say horse sat on mat? No, because horse doesn't sit down. Have you ever seen a horse which was sitting down? They don't sit. I hope you even realize this biological fact that they when they sleep also they don't sit. घोड़ा खड़े खड़े सोता है. लेट्स नॉट गो इन दैट बायोलॉजी, राइट? सेट को रिप्लेस करते हैं. कैन आई से कैट जंप्ड ऑन मैट? यस. कैन आई से कैट लाइड ऑन मैट? यस. कैन आई से कैट डाइड ऑन मैट?
यस.
तो मैं इसको भी रिप्लेस कर सकता हूँ. कैन वी रिप्लेस मैट ऑल्सो? यस. कैट सेट ऑन सोफा, कैट सेट ऑन बेड, कैट सेट ऑन chair, whatever. Say as many. What I'm saying is, a good student who wants fluency in language should be good at vertical axis. Right? You ever want to speak the same statement again and again and again, not a problem. But motivational speakers, they use a lot of synonyms together. They use one word, replace it, and vertically a lot of words fall from top. You are playing a game. You have to be champion of word master. So you got my point? Do not bother about horizontal axis. Bother about vertical selection. Right? Sometimes the same sentence you can say from 10 perspective. Right? For instance, you are going to introduce or welcome His Holiness Dalai Lama. Let's say he came to our university. And you are saying the same sentence again and again. His Holiness Dalai Lama is here. We are very happy that he is here. I am overwhelmed that he is here. Right? Now, what writers? Ye cheez aapko humare Dharmdat Chaturvedi ji se seekhni chahiye. How will he say? He'll say, Tibet ke savior. Right? Bhagwan apne aap mein. You know the way he uses words, but it's an amazing quality. We all laugh most of the time on him, but I have realized this. He has an amazing quality. He replaces one word and he uses a lot of vertical words instead of that. Right? The jaise Gandhi ke liye bola jata hai. Gandhi will not say Gandhi is here. Will say Bapu is here. Mahatma is here. Right? The man who earned freedom is here. To main Shakespeare ki jagah aur kya likh sakta hu? The man who wrote 37 plays was a greatest writer of Renaissance era. Now I have used a phrase. All you have to do is when you are looking at the sentence like this, replace one phrase. It has to be verb phrase. Look, the category has to be same. A noun has to be a noun. ये यहाँ तो गिरेगा नहीं ना? जैसे cat sat on mat, jumped यहाँ नहीं गिरेगा. Jumped sat on mat. It is not a sentence, right? Or you say okay, died sat on jumped. क्यों गड़बड़ हो रही है? Because we forgot
कि जो कैटेगरी सेम होनी चाहिए, नाउन नाउन को रिप्लेस करेगा, वर्ब वर्ब को रिप्लेस करेगा, एडजेक्टिव एडजेक्टिव को रिप्लेस करेगा. एम आई मेकिंग सेंस? दिस थ्योरी इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड वी विल क्विकली टॉक अबाउट दैट थ्योरी. Right? So let me now just go quickly because some of the concepts if are clear in our mind, now rest of the PPTs will make better sense to all of you. Here, there was a theorist, linguist, Geoffrey Leach, who has written an amazing book, and he says that when we talk about meaning, so many types of meanings are available. Conceptual meaning, connotative meaning, social meaning, affective meaning, reflective meaning, collocative meaning, and thematic meaning. Out of these, connotative, social, affective, reflected, and collocative are associative meaning. Let me not explain boringly in a theory. Let me show it to you. What do I mean by that? Right? We usually, whenever we speak, right now the exercise which we did, that I said home and you said mother, I said home and you said Tibbal, right? Why is it happening? Because you are not looking for denotative meaning, dictionary meaning. You are looking for all the words which are associated with that. Right? This is known as connotative meaning. Right? For instance, look at that. In Bible, right? In Western civilization, nobody respects snake. India mein toh hum snake ki bhi puja karte hain. Naag panchmi hoti hai. Saap ko bhi doodh pilate hain. Right? But there, snake is a very, very repulsive. So, in Western civilization, you will say, a person is not trustworthy, they will not call him a dog, they will call him a snake. The reason is the story that Adam and Eve was seduced by Satan and it took the form of a snake to seduce Eve. So, snake ka denotative, yani snake, agar aap dictionary mein khol ke dekhoge, to kya hoga? Limbless, scaly, elongated, reptile, inhabiting tropical and temperate areas. But do you think this way? When I say snake, do you think this way? Did it happen? You'll say snake. Rukiye sir. Snake means limbless, scaly, elongated, scary. No, we don't think it. I'll say snake and suddenly an image came in your mind. I'll say tree. I'll say fan. Did you go for the meaning of the word? Image of the word. Human beings never ever speak, talk or communicate in the meaning. Then look at our faulty system. But we force you to learn the word meaning when you were kids. Yes, because that time for once you will have to know the word meaning. But sometimes you know students say ki sir kal 10 meaning ya 10 word yaad kiye the aur subah bhul gaye sir. You know why do we forget? You have to ensure that until the word gives you an image, right? You should not leave that word, right? So the word has given you an image in the mind, leave that word. You will always remember that word. So connotation. Now when I'll say snake, you will understand repulsive, scary, dangerous, and the biblical allusion tricked Adam and Eve into eating the forbidden fruit, right? So I'll say the poet has written a poem about snake. I will immediately understand that, oh, it is a Western poet and he is talking about biblical allusion. Right? So, meaning is not dictionary meaning. Meaning is connotative meaning. And we, 80% of the time, always think in connotative manner. Right? So, when somebody said, ghas khayega kya? Then you understood what that person was saying because that word meant something else. Right? Meaning. Every word, all the words will have two kind of meanings, right? Conceptual meaning and associative meaning. Let's learn it with some example, right? Look at that. Conceptual meaning. I will say the word money, right? And you will understand what does money mean. Ab dusra example dekhiye, associative meaning, right? And I'll say, look at this example. Somebody came and I'll said, he has money. And what will I say? I'll say, so what? I also have money. Then I'll say, no. He has money. Then I'll say, so what? I also have money. Then I'll say, no, you're not getting it. He is Ambani. Right? Then this guy will say, no, I'm Ambani. He's not Ambani. Now he is absolutely right. But still we say like this. He has money. He is Ambani. Now what do I mean by this? That person's name is not Ambani. Ambani is this. He'll get hurt. But we do speak like this. That means you mean to say that that person is damn richy, 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 rich guy. There is a movie's name like this, Richie Richie Rich. Right? So his friend says, makes his fun. He said, "Arey, you are Richie Richie Rich." He said, "No, that was till last year. Now my dad has more money. Now I am Richie 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 Rich." Right? So that whenever he gets more money, he adds up one Richie in front of his name. Right? That means money can mean rich, job, to work, tired, coin, poor, if you are thinking. Achha, ab aap bolo, sir, aapne bola tha rich, ye poor kahan se aa gaya? This is when you are going to think just opposite of that. When I'll say rich and somebody who is poor, he'll not think about the money. He'll say, rich, I don't have that. Right? So poor person will think. So remember, whenever you speak, the audience will interpret it accordingly. Some people will accordingly understand synonymous. Some people will say antonymous ideas. So those who are negative, and you are, that's why it happens. Why we always never think the same? मैं एक ही इंग्लिश बोल रहा हूँ ना, सबके कानों में एक ही जा रहा है, but आपके मन में emotion अलग अलग आ रहे हैं. How is it that possible? Is it that language is changing in this room? No. Is it because you already have a set of settled meaning present in your brain? Right? If you are a negative person, you are always trying to interpret my sentence negatively. That means, again, language is dependent on a lot of issues. That also comes under semantics. These are few sentences, right? Analyze these sentences. What's the problem with these sentences? How can you explain what the problem? Pehla sentence dekhiye. The hamburger ate the boy. Kya gadbad hai sentence mein? Yes, मैंने क्या किया है, सब्जेक्ट को ऑब्जेक्ट गड़बड़ हो गई है, तो मुझे सही सेंटेंस बोलना है, तो क्या करूंगा? The boy ate the hamburger. Right? दूसरा देखिए, the table listens to the radio. क्या गड़बड़ है इस सेंटेंस में? The table cannot listen to the radio, right? So either you will have to say man listens to the radio, he listens to the radio, or you will have to say the radio is on the table, or the playing radio is on the table, right? Like this, all these sentences are wrong. That means grammatically it may be correct, right? You need a subject, something, you need rephrasing of these sentences, and look at that, how do we do that, right? So now, there are four categories which will control it. हम जब इंग्लिश में कोई भी भाषा में बात करते हैं, द सेंटेंसेस आर कंट्रोल्ड बाय एक्शन, बाय टाइम, बाय लोकेशन, बाय इंस्ट्रूमेंट एंड स्टफ लाइक दिस. फॉर इंस्टेंस, लुक एट दैट, राइट? ये लिंग्विस्टिक मैथमेटिक्स की तरह होता है, एनिमेट थिंग. टेबल एनिमेट है, एनिमेट मतलब जिंदा है. जो क्या टेबल एनिमेट है? हॉर्स है, बॉय है, मैन, गर्ल, वुमन. बट लुक एट दैट सेकेंड वन, ह्यूमन, राइट? क्या टेबल ह्यूमन है? क्या हॉर्स, जो एनिमेट तो है बट क्या ह्यूमन है? नहीं. अगला देखिए, फीमेल. क्या टेबल फीमेल है? क्या हॉर्स फीमेल है? क्या बॉय फीमेल है? क्या मैन फीमेल है? क्या गर्ल? यस. वुमन? यस. एडल्ट. व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज, बिफोर यू यूज अ वर्ड, हम आपको क्या पढ़ाते हैं? सब्जेक्ट. अब हर सब्जेक्ट वहां नहीं आ सकता, राइट? अगर सब्जेक्ट आ सकता तो आई विल से टेबल इज ईटिंग अ हैमबर्गर. यू विल से नो इट्स रॉन्ग. आई विल से व्हाई? यू टॉट मी कि सब्जेक्ट लगाओ, वर्ब लगाओ और ऑब्जेक्ट लगा दो, तो दिस इज द सेंटेंस. आई विल से नो, यू मेड अ मिस्टेक, टेबल इज नॉट एनिमेट. सो यू हैव टू हैव लॉट ऑफ कैटेगरीज लाइक दिस. नाउ हाउ मेनी कैटेगरीज? आई कैन नॉट टीच यू ऑल द कैटेगरीज. वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट बेसिक इंपॉर्टेंट कैटेगरीज. दीज आर द कैटेगरीज व्हिच यू आर गोइंग टू टॉक. एजेंट, थीम, इंस्ट्रूमेंट, एक्सपीरियंसर, लोकेशन, सोर्स एंड गोल. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस. लुक एट दैट, द बॉय किक्ड द बॉल. इसमें एजेंट कौन है? एजेंट मीन समबडी हु इज डूइंग. कैन आई से अ बॉल किक्ड द बॉय? नो, राइट? बट कैन आई मेक अ पैसिव ऑफ दिस सेंटेंस? यस. एंड आई कैन से दैट अ बॉल वॉज kicked by boy, right? So this is agent and the theme. The theme is the object or person that is directly affected, which grammatically you called object. Theme ko kya kehte hain? Object, right? Look at the next one. instrument and experiencer. The boy cut his hair with the scissors. Right? Can I say scissors cut the boy's hair? No, will not make sense, right? But by scissors, with the scissors, because it's an instrument. So look at that another. This is an instrument and experiencer is this boy. And instrument is scissors. And I always tell you, scissors is always plural, right? I'll leave these PPTs, so something which is not important, I'm going quickly, so don't worry about that, right? Then comes location, source, and goal. So look at this sentence. The keys are next to the vase. For instance, you say, keys are in the home. Hamari everyday language boli hai. Aapka ek friend hai, and you said, aray, I forgot my keys, get the keys. And that was, where are the keys? I can't find it. Then you will have to add more semantic thing. You'll say, keys are near the table. Then it say, where is the table? I can't find the table. Right? Then you say, the table is near the keys. Then you'll say, I can't find the keys. Then you'll say, keys are near the table. Table is near the key. And you'll go on. That means now you need more help. Then you will say, in the left side, near the TV, table. And then the key. Then you will say, oh, you should have said TV. Now look at that. I'm searching keys, but you found the keys with TV. What TV had to do with the location, right? To avoid confusion, just main apna ek example do personal, it's a very funny example. First time I had gone to Hyderabad for my education and I sat down in the cab, Ola, right? And I was talking to somebody on the phone, right? So I had this habit ki agla koi baat kar raha hai, toh I'll say right. Yeah, yeah, right, right. Aur cab wale ne mujhe bola tha ki sir, mujhe nahi pata hai kahan hai university, aap direction batate jana. So when I'll say, yeah, yeah, right, wo bhai sahab right mood le. Right? Phir main thodi der, haan, right, right, right. Again, wo right mood liya. Aur mujhe airport se ghuma ke wapis city ke bahar le gaya. And when I cut the call, I said, ye toh hum bahar nahi aa gaye hain. Bole, bhai sahab, aap bhi toh bole, right, 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 right. Toh main right leta raha. I said, have you lost your mind or something? Then I realized, it's my mistake. Right? I said right, and of course, he was waiting for the word. So whenever he asked, and he was murmuring, sir, bhai sahab, right lu ya left lu? And I was talking on phone, right, right, right. Wo teen bar right le le. It can happen. Semantically, problems of such nature can happen. They may sound funny, but they make us aware about the nature of the language. Right? So location, source, and goal. Look at second. She brought some souvenirs from where? From France. Right? So I'll say, this is a pen. I'll say, haan, theek hai, phenk de. Then I'll say, no, no, no. This is the pen which Akbar used. Right? So I'll say, this is a leaf. Or I'll say, haan, theek hai, rakh do. I'll say, no, no. This is a leaf of the tree under which Buddha sat down and meditated. Then he'll say, acha, acha, give it to me. Now, how come suddenly when I added some more information, the same object became so important for you? You got my point. So while speaking, you have to be very careful that never speak the sentences which can be misunderstood by your audience. Always speak the sentences with extra location, source, goal, agency, experience, and whatever is necessary. So for instance, I'm delivering a lecture. A lot of teachers teach you. Sometimes, you know, we have teachers. I also had a lot of teachers. Whatever they will teach, they were good, but they could not understand what they were saying. Right? They were good in their subject, they are well-renowned people. But we don't understand what they are saying. Why? Because those people have a problem in semantics. Right? Even the native speaker, Angreji padhane ke liye, London ke teacher aake bhi aapko nahi samjha paayenge kai baar. Aapko lagega, isse achha toh hamare Sarnath wale sir the. Hai na? Chaturvedi ji kitna achha samjhate the Sanskrit. Yahan Germany mein aake isko Sanskrit bhi nahi aati hai. Because the person, it's not about education. It's about semantics. Right? Now, a traffic inspector who is guiding the traffic has to be very good at semantics, not speaking. Right? Aapne TV match ki anchoring suni hai na? Ab ek baat soch ke dekhiye ki TV match, cricket match ki jo anchoring kar raha hai, agar wo semantically fatafat achche se nahi karega, aap bore ho jao. But वो कितने अच्छे से करते हैं और उसने बॉल मारी और बाई तरफ मुड़ गई और चौका और ये गई उसके हाथ में एंड यू लिव दैट एक्सपीरियंस दैट मोमेंट इट इज नॉट अबाउट लैंग्वेज इट इज बिकॉज दैट पर्सन इज सिमेंटिकली ट्रेन्ड to make a visual in front of your eyes. Poets do that, good writers do that, we expect our students also to be good at that. For that you will have to be aware that language is not about speaking one sentence in proper grammar. Language is about putting every marker wherever it is necessary, right? Put it in the first instance, right? These are some of the sentences. I don't want to do that exercise, right? Because aap ye hai PPT mein, so please sit together and do this kind of exercise. Now we come to some interesting things which we just discussed. Ab language mein problem kaun se word paida karte hain, right? They are homophones, homonym, polysemy. What are homophones? Ye sentence dekhiye. Ab agar hamare pronunciation galat hai, tab to aap bach jaoge, right? कई स्टूडेंट्स इस वर्ड को कैसे यूज करते हैं, भालू को क्या बोलते हैं, बियर, राइट सर मेरे पास बियर है, बियर से नहीं, नहीं नहीं बियर नहीं पीनी मुझे, अरे पीनी नहीं सर मेरे पास बियर है सर बियर, अरे भाई वो वर्ड आप मिसप्रोनाउंस कर रहे हो, द वर्ड इज बेयर, राइट। अब ये भी वर्ड बेयर है, आई एम गोइंग बेयर फुटेड, बेयर, राइट। अब प्रोनाउंसिएशन दूसरा देखिए, मीट, this is also meat, flower, this is also flower, pale, this is also pale, right, this is also right, ये मैंने आपको बताया था उस दिन, so इसको हम अगर shoe बोल रहे हैं तो फिर आप बच गए, but बचने के साथ आपने अर्थ का अनर्थ भी कर दिया। shoe क्या है, SUE, to file a case on another person, right, and look at this, two. Now this problem comes. I had a student earlier, right? Who will come and he'll say, "Sir, I will meet you at 8." Gujarati, आपने वो movie देखी है? That Sanjay Dutt's movie? Sanju. There is an interesting scene where one Gujarati fellow comes and what does he say? He says, "अरे बाबा, बाहर hall में ना snake पड़ा है, खा लेना." गुजराती थोड़ा ऐसे बोलते हैं, तुलसे तुलसे क्या क्या पड़ा है, अरे बाहर होल में, होल, सो इज नॉट सेइंग हॉल, राइट, ही इज सेइंग हो, आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड, राइट। एंड स्नैक्स को क्या बोल रहा है, स्नेक, सो इज सेइंग अरे बाबा बाहर होल में ना स्नेक पड़ा है, खा लेना। नाउ दिस काइंड ऑफ सेंटेंस कैन बी प्रिटी प्रिटी, इट हैपेंस बिकॉज़ वी आर नॉट कैपेबल टू फाइंड होमोफोन्स। नाउ व्हाई फोन्स, बिकॉज़ इट इज रिलेटेड विद फोनेटिक्स। If you mispronounce a word, आपके word का कचरा हो सकता है, right? Okay. Homonym, look at this sentence. Pupil, right? Pupil का एक sentence meaning आप सबको पता है, disciple. But the another pupil is in your eye, inside eye, right? This is also known as pupil, in the eye. और इसी से एक phrase भी बना है, right? He is the people of my eye, right? He is an apple of my eye. अब आप बोलो apple of an eye? सर आपने आँख पे apple लगवा रखी है? Apple of the eye का क्या मतलब होता है? If I say don't touch him, don't hurt him, he is an apple of my eye. Very, very close to your heart. Something which is your phone can be an apple of your eye. Your bike can be apple of your eye. अब आपको वो expression आ ही नहीं रहा है, immediately we will face the problem of semantics, right? So let's pick up one by one, and I'll quickly do some exercises with you. Synonyms. A problem in synonyms is some synonyms are exact synonyms, some synonyms are little bit far away from those words. For instance, look at that. Almost, nearly, big, large, broad, wide, buy, purchase, cab, taxi, car, automobile, couch, sofa, freedom, liberty. They are almost like identical to each other, right? So what should you do? Learn a lot of synonyms, because when I said vertical axis se girega, what I was saying basically, find out the synonyms, right? If sometime you don't find synonym, find out the category. I can say cat sat on mat. I can say animal sat on mat. Because cat belongs to the big category animal only, right? So like that we can say the same thing and can avoid repetition also. So synonyms. Second, antonyms. You know about antonyms, they are opposite. And these things you will have to learn in English. ये आपको अपने आप नहीं आते हैं. यू विल हैव टू वर्क हार्ड एंड लर्न बाय हार्ट व्हाट आर द सिनोनिम्स, व्हाट आर द एंटोनिम्स. दीज यू नो. सो लेट्स नॉट टॉक अबाउट दिस. लेट्स टॉक समथिंग व्हिच इज न्यू टू यू, व्हिच इज हाइपोनिम. व्हाट इज एन हाइपोनिम? आई जस्ट गिव यू द एग्जांपल. कैट इज एन एनिमल, डॉग इज अ पूडल, वेजिटेबल इज अ कैरट, फ्लावर अ रोज. सो यू कैन से गिव मी अ फ्लावर. फ्लावर शॉप पे जाके आप बोले गिव मी अ फ्लावर, तो फ्लावर शॉप वाला और देखेगा ना आपकी तरफ, राइट? जैसे आप कैब में बैठे, थोड़ा सा सोचिए हमारी सिमेंटिक्स कैसी. आप कैब में बैठ के क्या बोलते हैं? चल. क्या कैब चलना शुरू हो जाएगी? कैब वाला क्या पूछेगा? कहा कैब तो है ही, इसलिए ना चल. आप फ्लावर शॉप में जाओ और बोलो फूल देना, तो आपकी तरफ देखेगा और आप देखो अबे देख क्या रहा है, फूल देना, तो बोलेगा हाँ भाई साहब कौन सा. आप मेडिकल शॉप पे जाओ और बोलो मेडिसिन देना, राइट? बट आप अगर एक कॉमन शॉप पे जाए जहां पे मॉल है सब बिक रहा है, वहां जाके बोले फूल देना, तो शायद वो समझ जाएगा और वही फूल देगा विच इज अवेलेबल. हाउ इज इट एसोसिएटेड विद सिमेंटिक्स? बी वेरी केयरफुल दैट व्हेन यू आर यूजिंग अ स्पेसिफिक एग्जांपल यू हैव टू स्पेसिफाई इट विद मोर एडजेक्टिव्स, राइट? जैसे आप कुशन खरीदने गए, शर्ट खरीदने गए, सो मेक इट वेरी क्लियर. अब आपको पता है शर्ट की दुकान है और आप वहां जाके बोले हाँ भाई साहब हम करते हैं, हम बोलते हैं शर्ट की दुकान पे गए भाई साहब एक शर्ट देना, तो यहाँ पे क्या सांप देंगे आपको, राइट? अब वो आपसे पूछेगा हाँ भाई साहब कैसा दिखाऊं, तो हम नॉर्मली क्या टोकन है, हाँ भाई साहब 5000 वाला, तो आपकी हैकड़ाई निकल जाती है, राइट? अब बोलते हैं अरे 5000 वाला तो मैंने कल ही लिया था, है ना, मेरे पास बहुत हो गए 5000 वाला, कोई 1000 वाला है तो दिखाओ. ह्यूमन बीइंग्स वी विल नेवर से कि भाई 5000 तो मेरा बजट से बाहर है, 1000 वाला दिखाओ. विल नॉट से दिस वे. अगेन इफ द शॉपकीपर इज गुड, कई शॉपकीपर इतने टैलेंटेड होते हैं, जानते हैं, आपको आते हुए देखेंगे, आपको ऊपर से नीचे तक देखेंगे और बोलेंगे ये 1000 रुपए वाला ले जाओ भाई साहब, तो आपका ईगो हट, आप बोले 1000 वाला क्या समझो, 5000 का दे मुझे, बोले भाई साहब आपकी शक्ल देख के नहीं लग रहा है कि 5000 वाला लो. अब देखिए आपने कम्युनिकेट तो नहीं किया, राइट? बट द शॉपकीपर्स द सेम वे द टीचर्स द सेम वे पुलिस इंस्पेक्टर्स वी ऑल आर ट्रेन्ड इन सिमेंटिक्स. Something which your body language is capable to tell us. Something which sometime आप होते हैं ना कि सर आज मैं क्लास में नहीं आऊंगा. You don't have to say, we'll say चलो क्लास में, and you will give us the look. No, sir, आ रहे हैं सर. So we understand that it's more. It's enough. We have communicated well, right? Hyponym, some example. Look at that. Living thing, creature, plant. A plant को फिर divide किया है. Vegetable, flower, tree. Vegetable, carrot, flower, rose, tree, banyan, pine. So instead of saying banyan, I can also say living thing. Right? I can also say plant. I can also say tree. Yani aap same word repeat mat kijiye. Sirf mat boliye Shakespeare was a writer. Say a dramatist. Shakespeare was a poet. Shakespeare was a dramatist. Shakespeare was a man of letter. Shakespeare was a Renaissance artist. Right? But related with category. आप बोले सर समझ गए, कुछ भी बोल देना, शेक्सपियर वॉज अ बाइसिकल आर्टिस्ट और शेक्सपियर वॉज अ जोकर. नो, यू कांट से दैट. यू गॉट माय पॉइंट? प्रोटोटाइप. व्हाट आर द प्रोटोटाइप्स? प्रोटोटाइप्स इज, आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड अ प्रोटोटाइप. समटाइम यू डोंट स्पीक द नेम ऑफ द थिंग बट यू स्पीक वाया लोगो. जैसे मैंने अभी एग्जाम्पल दिया, राइट? रिच आदमी अमीर कितना है वो कैसे, जैसे मैं पंजाब में गया एक बार, राइट? तो पंजाब में मैंने कारें देखी, सबके पास या तो फॉर्च्यूनर या ऑडी. उसी बीच में मुझे एक छोटी सी कार दिखी, मारुति ऑल्टो, राइट? ऐसा कहते हैं कि पंजाब में चाहे घर नहीं हो, चाहे लोन लेके लो, बट गाड़ी बड़ी होनी चाहिए, बड़ी. अब उससे क्या होता है, देन आई आस्क वन ऑफ माय फ्रेंड, मैंने कहा भाई साहब ऑल्टो हो तो क्या प्रॉब्लम है, बोले लड़की की शादी नहीं होती है. आई सर लड़की की शादी का ऑल्टो 800 से क्या लेना देना है, बोले सर पहले वो ये देखते हैं कि कार कौन सी, वो लड़का नहीं देखते हैं. तो इमेजिन कीजिए एक सीन, लड़के वाले आए और बोले गाड़ी कौन सी है भाई साहब, तो बोले सर ऑडी, हाँ रिश्ता पक्का है. अरे भाई गाड़ी से शादी कर रहे, लड़के को ऐसा राजस्थान में भी होता है, हमारे यहाँ भी अलग अलग कास्ट में हमें पता है कि कोई बोल रहा है कि सर राजपूत लड़की है. अब देखिए सेमेंटिक्स, राइट? तो लड़का कभी नहीं बोलेगा कि मुझे लड़की से मिलना है, राजपूत में वो नहीं मिलने देते, राइट? और राजपूत है तो पता है कि आपको बहुत सारा सोना देना पड़ेगा, राइट, वो बोलेगा सर लड़का तो सुनार है, सुनार है मतलब सोना तो आपको ऐसे तोल तोल के, जितना लड़का जितने किलो का है उतना आपको देना पड़ेगा। दिस इज द सेमेंटिक्स ऑफ सोसाइटी, राइट। फॉर इंस्टेंस प्रोटोटाइप्स, जैसे देखिए कुछ प्रोटोटाइप्स है ना इंडिया में, हर कंट्री में कितने गंदे और खतरनाक प्रोटोटाइप्स भी हैं, राइट। लैंग्वेज देखिए, एक लैंग्वेज मैं सम टाइम मैंने वॉच दिस शो कपिल शर्मा शो, आई जस्ट हेट इट। व्हाई डू आई हेट इट? बिकॉज ही हैज सेंटेंसेस लाइक दिस, अरे चूड़िया पहन रखी है। अब आपको इस सेंटेंस में कुछ गलत नहीं लग सकता, राइट, बट हमने क्या किया है, चूड़ियां जो औरतों के पहनने की चीज है उसको हमने कायरता के साथ जोड़ दिया, राइट। और जब मैं किसी को बोलता हूं चूड़िया पहन रखी है क्या, यू आर इंसल्टिंग अ वुमन ऑल्सो बिकॉज यू आर कॉलिंग अ मैन हु इज अ वुमन लाइक। नाउ व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सिमेंटिक्स इज दिस? आदमी बोलेगा नहीं नहीं चूड़िया नहीं, मैंने तो घड़ी पहन रखी है। नाउ दिस इज नॉट द लिटरल मीनिंग, दिस इज द प्रोटोटाइप, राइट। जैसे मैं बोलता हूं तिब्बत, right, so suddenly the ideas which come in the mind is His Holiness Dalai Lama, right, China, yak, and today I learned some new words for the Tibetan beer, right, chang, right, so these are the words which are associated with that, these are prototypes. जैसे मैं बोलूँ कि अरे उसके पास तो Apple का मोबाइल है, Adidas का ट्राउजर है, right, और Rolex की घड़ी, तो क्या वो हट में रहेगा? नहीं रहेगा ना। आजकल आपने रैप सॉन्ग देखे हैं ना, बादशाह, बादशाह को देखा है आपने, 50 तोला का तो सोना पहन के घूमता है, राइट, बिकॉज़ एंड द रैप आर्टिस्ट हैव बिकम लाइक दिस, दिस इज द सिमियोटिक्स ऑफ आवर कल्चर। यू डोंट हैव टू फाइंड मीनिंग इन लैंग्वेज, एवरीथिंग इज अ लैंग्वेज। द वे आई वॉक, द वे आई, द काइंड ऑफ क्लोथ्स व्हिच यू वियर, द काइंड ऑफ फोन आई कैरी, इट इज नॉट अ लैंग्वेज बट इट विल टेल मी अबाउट, right, prototype. Homophones, homonyms, the same example, bear, meat, flower, pail, right, they can create confusion. What kind of confusion? You remember my first sentence, meet me near the bank, it will immediately. So always qualify, always remember, as a good writer when you are writing in your exam or writing a story, please qualify your noun so that the confusion can be minimized, right. Not important, so I'm just skipping all these things and let's directly come to, yeah, this is very interesting. Collocations. What are collocations? Collocations are the categories which are associated with words, right? For instance, look at that, time. Time ke saath hum kya kya use karte hain? Free time, have a great time, have a hard time, have time, it's about time, just in time, keep time, kill time, leisure time, make time, and go on. Never ever learn a word alone. Learn a word with its collocation. Collocation कैसा है? मैं बोलूँ camel. Camel बोलते ही आपके दिमाग में क्या आना चाहिए? रेगिस्तान, maybe राजस्थान, maybe पानी की कमी. All that, because you have to understand a word in its collocation. Right? So you understood the meaning of collocation? For instance, a quick example. Look at that. कॉलोकेशन एग्जाम्पल फॉर इंग्लिश लर्नर, राइट। ये कई बार हुआ है कि एक स्टूडेंट को पूछा जाता है कि बेड बिछाना, हम कहते हैं ना अरे बिस्तर लगा दो, इसकी इंग्लिश 1000 में से कोई एक स्टूडेंट कर पाता है, एक अभी वर्ड दूंगा ऐसा आप नहीं कर पाओगे, राइट। इसको क्या बोलते हैं हम? मेकिंग अ बेड। आप बोलो सर मेकिंग अ बेड तो कारपेंटर करता है, नहीं, बिस्तर बिछाने को इंग्लिश में क्या बोलते हैं? You cannot ask for the reason. English is an eccentric language like this. It's an expression. You will have to learn it by heart. Making a bed. Doing homework. Saving time. Doing the dishes. You don't say washing the dishes. If you are saying wrong. You will have to say, I am doing the dishes. Aap bole, doing the dishes? Kyunki hum kya karte hain? Hindi mein sochte hain. Doing the dishes means dishes kar raha hai. No. It is just the way we speak. For instance, an idiom. I'll say, my grandpa has kicked the bucket. आप बोलोगे अरे सर आपके ग्रैंडपा तो बड़े तंदुरुस्त हैं, बकेट को लात मार दिया, right? My grandpa has kicked the bucket. तो मैं आपके पास आऊं और बोलूं, my grandpa has kicked the bucket. Please come tomorrow. ना आप बोलो है ये क्या हुआ? तो kicked the bucket का मतलब क्या होता है? मर जाना. Kicked the bucket is an idiom. That means the person is dead. अब हम लोगों के लिए जिनको अगर मीनिंग नहीं पता है, आप बोलो अरे बड़े तंदुरुस्त है दादाजी, बहुत अच्छा बहुत अच्छा, और टिक करो बकेट को. He has kicked the bucket. He is gone out of this world. Idioms. Semantics का अगला चैलेंज क्या है? Idioms. Phrasal verbs. जब एक कम्युनिटी दूसरे कम्युनिटी का मजाक उड़ाती है ना, राइट? सो लेट्स से समटाइम आई विल से अ सेंटेंस इन तिब्बतियन लैंग्वेज, इट विल मीन समथिंग, देन इन योर लैंग्वेज ऑल ऑफ यू लाफ एंड आई विल स्टैंड आउटसाइड ऑफ एंड आई थिंक व्हाट इज रॉन्ग बिकॉज़ आई हैव नॉट अंडरस्टूड दैट idiom. सम लैंग्वेजेस हैव idiomatic expression, राइट? Okay, now I can have 5-10 minutes, right? Because this is the second part. I have explained everything. I'll just quickly show you via images. Here we are going to talk about semiotics. What is semiotics? This is semiotics. If I'll show you these, I don't need language. Will I say, ye dekho khush hona, ye dekho sad, ye dekho question? Aisa koi nahi bolega. We understood that these emoticons has these meanings, right? These means these people have. Now, I had drama. अगर आप कभी drama theatre की training करने जाते हैं ना, तो आपको check कैसे करते हैं? सबसे पहले वो बोलता है, चलो, I will talk about emotion, show it on your face. Then I'll say sad, happy, surprised, confused वाला था ये, surprised वाला था, right? So things like that will happen. Now, this is also semiotics. You remember Charlie Champion? Charlie Champion was a real champion of this, right? He used to do all these things on his face. You may also know one character from your country or your friend who is capable to show all the semiotic expression on the face rather than saying it with mouth, right? Now, from where this theory came? What is this theory? This is an amazing theory given by the father of English linguistics. Whatever we have been learning so far, linguistic. Linguistic ke param poojaniya pitaji ka kya naam tha? Ferdinandi Saussure. Saussure never had written a book, right? And in case you are surprised, the man who became father of English language did his PhD on Panini's Ashtadhyayi. Saussure ने अपनी पीएचडी का काम किस पे किया है? पाणिनि की अष्टाध्यायी यानी संस्कृत पे और अंग्रेजी की ग्रामर की किताब लिखी. इन्होंने कभी किताब नहीं लिखी. He was a teacher. He used to give lectures in the class based on the lecture from the student. इसीलिए कहते हैं नोट्स ढंग से लिखा करो, right? Because notes can be pretty careful. From the notes of the students, 1916 में पहली बार इंग्लिश ग्रामर की किताब आई. तो आप सोचिए ग्रामर कितनी रिसेंट है. 1916, right? We had first clear-cut grammatical rules book and Saussure changed everything. What was the basic concept of Saussure? Saussure said, this is how we talk and communicate. I am speaking something, so I am using a message, my mouth, it is going from my mouth and you are receiving with your ear and you decode it, right? And then you understand it, you say something and the process goes on and on. I wish it could have been so easy as it looks here, right? So he came up with a theory and he said, look at that. Whatever you speak is known as parole, right? And a whole community, for instance, right now when I'm talking to you in a language, our grammars are same. That's why you are capable to understand me. That means I'm controlled by a lang. Kya bola Saussure ne isko? Lang. Lang is the invisible grammatical rules which are here on my head, but you can't see it. So I am controlled by that grammar and now I am paroling. So I am langing and I am paroling. Don't speak like this, I am just giving you a phrase, right? I am langing and paroling. Langing and paroling, right? So you listen, you are also covered by this lang. So because our langs are same, we understand each other's grammar, right? So if there is a good speaker of English but he is nervous, police wale kaise pakadte hain? Police wale puchhenge kahan ja raha tha, to aap bologe ja raha tha main to ghar pe ja raha tha to main to, aur aap phans jaoge kyunki aapne kya hua, aapki lang gadbad ho gayi, right? To kya sikha raha hu, chahe kabhi bhi phans jaye simple sentence mein lang bol ke nikal lijiye wahan se, right? Don't skip, otherwise you will be entrapped. This is how they find it out. Now, this is the greatest contribution of Saussure. Saussure said that everything is a sign. Every word is a sign. A teacher is a sign of authority, vice chancellor is a sign, students are sign, and every sign has two parts. Signifier, signified. When I say tree, did the meaning come or did the image come?
Image.
Image. So he said, when I speak T-R-E-E, tree, it's a sound, right? It is known as signifier. Or jo image aayi aapke dimaag mein, tree, for instance, I'll say fan. What happened? Image came. When I say dog, image came. So dog, when I spoke, it's a signifier. And the image which came in your mind is a signifier. Right? So look at this. Signifier, signified. Tree, tree. This is signifier, this is signified. Dono kabhi yaad mat rakhiyega, ek yaad rakhiye. Right? So fire, muh se fire kiya aapne. वर्ड को बोला सिग्निफायर याद रखिए दूसरा अपने आप याद हो जाएगा सिग्निफाइड क्योंकि कुछ बचा ही नहीं है वरना क्या होता स्टूडेंट कंफ्यूज हो जाता है पहले खुश है फिर आधे घंटे सिग्निफाइड क्या था वो वाला था या वो सिग्निफाइड आप याद मत कीजिए ना आप सिग्निफायर याद रखिए राइट तो अब मैंने क्या किया मैंने एग्जैक्ट सिग्निफायर बोलते एक इमेज दिमाग में लाइए गन की मुंह से गन से बंदूक निकल रही है राइट सो आई एम फायरिंग सिग्निफायर वर्ड राइट तो बस आपके दिमाग में भी वही हुआ सिग्निफायर और सिग्निफाइड बन गया नेवर एवर लीव अ वर्ड अंटिल यू हैव एन इमेज इन योर माइंड राइट यू विल नेवर फॉरगेट दैट वर्ड इमेज इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट राइट सो व्हेन आई ओपनली से हिज होलीनेस दलाई लामा ऑल द वर्ड्स व्हिच आर कमिंग इनटू योर माइंड राइट आर एसोसिएटेड विथ हिज बिग ऑरा हिज कंपैशन हिज एज द वे ही लुक्स यू विल नॉट टॉक अबाउट अ मैन You will talk about all the things associated. Am I making sense? So will you always remember signifier? Banduk? Remember only one, sound image. Signifier, sound image, fire. Right? This is something I was trying to teach you. Right? Saussure said that whenever human beings are trying to speak something, they first produce sound. Right? So iska kya sound hai? ब, प, ई, ट, अब इनसे मैं कितने वर्ड बना सकता हूं देखिए प की जगह ऊपर से गिराइए स को सिट बिट पिट किट हिट राइट तो हमारे एक इंग्लिश के टीचर थे वो क्या करते थे वो बोलते थे दो वर्ड लिखते थे और बोलते थे ए से जेड तक शुरू हो जाओ राइट जैसे आई आर लिखा और हम बोलते थे एयर बोले हाँ वर्ड है बियर नहीं है कियर नहीं है डियर ऐसे वो बुलवाते थे पूरा एंड वी यूज टू एवरी स्टूडेंट यूज टू डू दिस इट्स अ वेरी गुड एक्सरसाइज राइट व्हाट यू हैव टू डू इज द ये याद नहीं रहे तो कोई बात नहीं है पैराडिग्मेटिक क्या होता है सिंटैग्म में ये याद रखिए वर्टिकल एक्सिस अलाउज यू टू मेक अ चॉइस एंड सिंटैग्मेटिक एक्सिस अलाउज यू टू हैव कॉम्बिनेशन लेट्स मेक सेंटेंसेस लेट्स सी लुक एट दैट द मैन क्राइड राइट मैन को रिप्लेस करके क्या डाल सकता हूं द बॉय क्राइड द मैन सैंग द मैन डाइड द मैन क्राइड द बॉय सैंग द बॉय डाइड द बॉय क्राइड और अच्छा देखना है ये देखिए राइट लुक एट दैट द रिडिकुलस गर्ल फेल इन टू द पॉन्ड अब देखिए वर्टिकल कुछ वर्ड्स गिर रहे हैं लेट्स रिप्लेस दैम The silly girl fell into the pond. The foolish girl fell into the pond. The funny girl fell into the pond. The crazy girl fell into the... Go on. Achha, ab isse kitne sentence bana sakte hain? It depends on your imagination. I can do like this. The ridiculous and silly girl jumped into the pond and died into the sea. It's up to you. Don't look at this. Don't look at horizontal, look at vertical. All I'm saying is, the one person who is good at these will always be able to speak fluently. Because you have one word which can be replaced by another word and words fall from top. So, aap apne dimag mein kuch sentences banaiye. Right? Ab aapne ye notice kiya? Girl, person, woman, lady, princess, child, fell, jumped, tripped, plunged, ये सारी verb हैं, ये सारे noun, इस तरह से ये सारे adjective, ये जरूर same होना चाहिए. Am I making myself clear to all of you? Right? So what is the most important thing in semantics and semiotics? Not horizontal, the base sentence. Whenever you are making a sentence, try to be quick and see that, okay, instead of saying that I am going, I'll say I am taking your leave. Right? Or semantically, excuse me. And then go. Because you are saying, excuse me, I'm going. Right? So from where do the words come? Words come if we know their synonyms, if we know their association, if we know their, right? So I'll say, he's not a soldier, he's a lion. Right? What did I say? He's not a soldier, he's a lion. Right? He is a king, he is a lion. Right? And negative, he's a donkey. Right? And we do speak metaphorically like this. Right? Ke, aray, ye to Raja hai, aray, ye to Salman Khan hai. Right? अरे ये तो शाहरुख खान है. राइट right? इस तरह से जब हम सेंटेंसेस बोलते हैं, यू आर यूजिंग सिमेंटिक प्लेस वर्ड वेयर यू आर स्ट्रेचिंग द पावर ऑफ इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज. ऑल आई एम सेइंग इज, अब से जब भी सेंटेंस बनाए ना, इसको बनाते समय एक बार उसको रिप्लेस कीजिए. जरूरी नहीं है सिनोनिम से, एंटोनिम से भी कर सकते हैं. राइट right? और सोशियर गेव एन अमेजिंग थ्योरी. सोशियर सेड, व्हाई ब्लैक इज ब्लैक. Because, आप बोलो सर, ब्लैक इज ब्लैक बिकॉज इट्स ब्लैक. Saussure said no. Black is black because it's neither red, nor blue, nor white, nor pink, nor. Why? Cat is cat because it's neither red, nor hat, nor mat, nor. So look at this theory. Saussure said a word has its meaning not because it has its meaning, because it is different from other. जब भी आप छोटे बच्चों को कुछ सिखाए ना, उसे ये मत बोलिए दिस इज एप्पल. शो फाइव फ्रूट्स एंड से दिस इज एप्पल बिकॉज दिस इज बनाना, दिस इज वाटरमेलन एंड दिस इज गुआवा. द किड्स माइंड विल ग्रास्प एवरीथिंग क्विकली. अ गुड टीचर नेवर टीचेस वन थिंग टू द स्टूडेंट्स. वी ऑलवेज टीच इन कंपेरिजन. राइट? सो व्हेन आई एम टीचिंग लिटरेचर टू माई स्टूडेंट, आई विल से चार्ल्स डिकेंस. Oh, he can be bracketed with Jane Austen and Thomas Hardy and William Shakespeare. तो आप बोलो Shakespeare से compare किया, इसको मतलब बड़ी बात है. You understood the meaning. I did not say Charles Dickens is a great writer. What did I say? Charles Dickens can be bracketed with William Shakespeare. The moment I compare the things, right? Human mind always works because things are different from each other. Right? आपने बहुत मीठा खा लिया है, तो आप क्या खाना चाहते हो? नमकीन. Your heart, this is also semantics of intentionality. Right? You do not need not to know everything. Kisko kya bolte hai? Syntagmatic hi bolte hai. Ye mat yaad kijiye. Paradigmatic. But kaise ban raha hai, ye jaroor dhyan. Right? So I want all of you to do one thing. Now onwards. Whenever you are talking, please talk slowly. Right? And you all meditate. It will help you a lot. Think about this. That what I am saying, can I replace it with some other words? If I use antonyms, the meaning will be just opposite. If I want to say the same thing, I will use synonyms. Right? So how many ways you can say the same sentence? If you can get mastery over this, you can improve your writing skills and you can be a very good speaker. Very good speaker. You will go on the stage, you will say the same thing, but you will say with a vibrancy, a lustrousness, a gravity, which is going to not only encapsulate, but encapture, mesmerize, transform, metamorphosize the audience. Look at what I did right now. When we are teaching you, we are not only teaching you, we are going to change you, transform you, metamorphosize you, right? All these are synonyms. And I used and it sounded good. That's exactly what we expect from. Always learn the words in clusters. Cluster as opposite, cluster as synonym. Right? जो मैंने अभी आपको बताया ना, homonym and all, ये that, छोटे बच्चों को पता है आजकल ऑक्सफोर्ड का एक ट्रेनिंग चला है, फोनिक्स, ऑक्सफोर्ड फोनिक्स. बच्चों को कैसे पढ़ाया जाता है? उनको बोलते हैं ओ, राइट? ओवल शेप ओ है. You will have to round your lips. अब बोलते हैं कि ऐसे सारे वर्ड बोलो जिसमें ओ आता है. Right? I have my nephew, वो घर में ऐसे ही पूरे दिन फिर ओ घूमता रहता है, वो मुंह से बोल हो जाता है एकदम से. right? So you'll say so go, right? But the moment you'll say क्या do को ऐसे बोल सकता हूँ? Do को ऐसे बोल सकता हूँ? Go की तरह go dog नहीं बोल सकते. This is the training of phonetics. This is the training of semiotics. This is the training which is associated with learning. Right? So am I making sense? What is semantics and semiotics? It is the meaning of the signs. You know the word, fair enough. But now, how do you use the words in the sentences? Right? That's all. Anybody has any doubt, question you want to share with me? Anything? You never ask anything. How is that possible? उसकी एक ही पॉसिबिलिटी है दैट इधर आई एम अ वेरी बैड टीचर राइट और आई एम अ वेरी गुड टीचर बोथ द थिंग्स आर नेवर पॉसिबल विद द टीचर बिकॉज़ इन सच अ लॉन्ग लेक्चर आई माइट हैव फॉलन एट अ लॉट ऑफ प्लेसेस आई माइट हैव एम्युलेटेड एंड सरपास माइसेल्फ एट अ लॉट ऑफ प्लेसेस नथिंग चलिए सो आई विल से दैट आई एम अ वेरी गुड टीचर इंस्टेड ऑफ सेइंग दैट आई एम अ बैड टीचर लेट्स टॉक अबाउट गुड थिंग्स सो Now, you are left with two more lectures, right? Next week, one lecture is given by Jasmeet sir, pragmatics. And then I'm going to again come into the picture with sociolinguistics, psycholinguistics, and one of my favorite topic, applied linguistics. Whatever you learned so far, can you apply it somewhere on a text? Can you, next semester, I came to know that here some of our students even have, what do you call it, fine arts students. 1 week we are going to give you lecture, actually whole week I will give you lecture on how to read a painting, right? And then how to read a movie, I did not say watch a movie, right? We will make you aware about shade, about color, about dimension, about how flat, everything has its meaning, right? इसीलिए कुछ building आप देखते क्या बोलते हो अरे कितना बढ़िया है ये तो राइट मार्केट में शर्ट खरीदे यही चाहिए मेरे को कितने भी रुपए का हो यही चाहिए मेरे को ये कौन सी चीज है जो आपसे बात कर रही है इज इट द कलर इज इट द शेड इट इज द और फिर जब आप प्राइस हम बोलते हैं ना कि किताब खरीदते हो सबसे पहले क्या देखते हैं पैसा कोई भी चीज हो इंडियंस क्या करते हैं पहले जाते हैं पैसा देखते हैं 2000 रुपए ए ये तो कलर मेरे पास है हरे तीन है मेरे पास क्योंकि उसका पैसा 5000 है सफेद 500 रुपए का बोलो सफेद ले लेते हैं जबकि घर पे सफेद ज्यादा है राइट एंड इट्स नॉट दैट शॉपकीपर्स डोंट अंडरस्टैंड शॉपकीपर्स डू अंडरस्टैंड राइट एवरीबॉडी इज ट्रेन्ड इन द एरिया दे कम फ्रॉम व्हेन यू विल ट्राई टू बिकम टीचर बीएड में आप जब फोर्थ सेमेस्टर में जाते हैं फोर्थ ईयर में तब हम आपको यही सब सिखाते हैं राइट द सिमेंटिक्स एंड द सीमियोटिक्स ऑफ ह्यूमन इमोशंस राइट एक माँ को कब लगना चाहिए कि ये रोने वाला है जैसे अब आपकी शक्लों पे जो दिख रहा है ना सर आपको सिमेंटिक्स नहीं दिखाई पड़ रहा है भागो यहाँ से वी आर बोर्ड विद यू आई डू गेस इट आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू एंटरटेन यू बिकॉज़ इट सीम्स इट्स रेनिंग आउटसाइड राइट सो वी आर डन हियर विल सी यू नेक्स्ट वीक वेडनेसडे एंड फ्राइडे ऑन द रेगुलर टाइम थैंक यू सो मच